Good morning, beautiful people. The sun is shining. It's a beautiful day. Well, kind of. It's still cold out.
Siri is a jerk.
This is what life is right now. Anyways, oh my gosh. Good morning. It's April 30th. And today is moving day. This is the debate Steve and I are having right now. Is moving day the day when the truck comes, or is moving day the day when you drive to the location?
Or is it the day where you're moving, when you're driving there?
It's the day when the moving truck comes, right?
I don't know. My vote is moving day is the day that you're actually moving.
Okay. We're gonna have to agree to disagree with this one. But you guys are gonna have to clear that up for us because...
Clear the air.
Although I've moved across the country several times, I apparently don't know what moving day is.
I tried to ask Siri and this is what she said. Hey Siri, what is moving day?
Moving day is a tradition, but not a legal requirement, in the province of Quebec, Canada, dating from the time when the province used to mandate fixed terms for leases of rental properties. It falls on July 1st, which is also Canada Day.
See, moving day is actually Canada
Awkward.
Day.
Awkward.
It's actually Canada Day.
Let's disregard that conversation. It's 8:00 in the morning, which may be why we're a little loopy because we haven't had our coffee because our coffee machine broke. Okay, this is the story. We were at the hospital and we come back. We're gone for like 8 hours. We come back. Lily and Zoe have found a bag of rice under the pantry door, took it out under the pantry door, and ate it all. Ate the whole bag of raw rice. So Lily and Zoe basically exploded in our place. Out this way and out that way. And then that morning our coffee maker broke, so it was just a wonderful morning. But anyways, that's why we're getting coffee right now at Hubbard and Craven's, because we need coffee, obviously, because we're just out of it. And then we're gonna go to U-Haul right after, and then we're going to pick up the girls, go to my parents' house, drop them off, get some patio furniture that they're giving us, and then start the day. The movers come at noon. I hired a couple movers for a couple hours just to get the heavy stuff. So it's gonna be a crazy day. And then tomorrow we leave at 3 a.m. Steve is towing his, actually, this is a good question because people have been asking me this on Instagram. If you have two cars and a U-Haul, you'll wanna either tow your car in the back of the U-Haul and have the other person drive the second car, or you can pay to ship it, which is like $700 to $800. But to tow it in the back of a U-Haul, it's gonna be around $250. So you can save money there. All right, let the day begin. Stone man. All right, guys, I'm driving, so I'm not looking at the camera. We have a change of plans. So we got there to the U-Haul place and our 20-foot truck wasn't there yet. The people didn't return it last night, so they gave us a 26-foot truck. Same price and everything, but you guys, it is a monster. It's so freaking big. We were gonna give away our kitchen table, but now we don't even have to do that, so we're gonna bring that dang kitchen table with us. But it's very big, so now we are actually going to ship Steve's car, just because 26-foot truck plus a Camry on the back is going to be miserable. So we're just gonna pay the extra money and have it shipped to Denver. Oh my gosh, just wait till I show you guys this truck. Like, it's so big, but it's newer, so that's good for Steve because the U-Haul drive across the country is not fun. I've obviously moved across the country several times, but we've always had movers, and my family has a lot of stuff. So we used to have like a few semis of stuff, but we've never done like a U-Haul, so this shall be interesting. Truck, you guys, I'm just in shock. This is like a semi. I mean, obviously a semi is 50 feet and this is 26, but still so big. Okay, update, it is 2:15. The movers got done at 1:30, so it literally only took them an hour and 15 minutes to load the truck. That was insane because I've never experienced that before. And also they were the best I've ever seen. Being that I've moved a few times, I definitely know how the movers respond and everything and how they care for your stuff and how friendly they are. So we do it all, movers in Carmel, and they're very good. So highly recommend if you guys are ever moving here to hire them because they're so good. I'll show you the truck here. There it is. Beautifully packed. They did such a good job. The landlord is now coming at 4 here, and the house has to be beautiful. So we need to now clean the house from top to bottom and make sure it's perfect before she comes. We gotta clean the house! And the day is not even halfway over, so here we go.
Did Nana and Papa babysit you? Did you have so much fun?
Just got done with everything and we're so tired, so tired. But thankfully my parents have food made, so we came here and now we're about to eat, and it's a glorious feeling. A nice salad and some rice and chicken and sauce and vinyl and clotifer and Maxwell. Oh, she is savage. Lily, you're embarrassing me on film.
I'd rather be a
okay.
Oh my god!
There it is! And it's perfectly rounded, Zaka.
Do a dance.
Basketball.
Oh.
We left at 3:45 a.m. Still got 3 hours, so we got quite a bit of time to drive. But we made it to Colorado, and now we got... It literally, like, 3 hours seems like nothing to us now. So excited. And I have had a very emotional night and morning leaving my family. I don't want to get too into detail because I'm going to be sad, very sad talking about it, but it was just very sad leaving them. You know, we're just all very close, and it was really sad. My dad and mom woke up at 3 to send us off, say a prayer, and yeah, I don't want to talk about it because I'm going to get emotional, and it's like the freaking, one of the saddest things I've done in my lifetime, for sure. It may not seem like a big deal to people, but we are a very close family, especially with all the stuff we've had the last 8 to 10 years, just all the turmoil. And then with my dad being sick, our family's pretty close. So this is something that Steve and I have wanted to do for a very long time. Moved to Colorado. I've wanted to come back ever since I was 17, because I left when I was 17. Wanted to come back literally 2 months later. So this is something we want to do. We're excited to be a little more adventurous. There's not much to do for us in Indiana, and we love the outdoors. We need the sun. I think that we're going to be really happy, and we're going to be visiting our families a ton. So it's not goodbye, it's see you later. So wanted to update you guys. It's been a long day. I've never driven this far by myself before, but we're almost there, so. And the girls have been pretty good. Pretty good. The first few hours, they were crazy, but now I've just been a little angel sleeping in the bed. So we're almost there. Thank the Lord! We made it! And it's so beautiful in here! Here's the front door. And here's the living room. Huge, huge, huge windows. Light fixtures. Everything is so brand new. This is a brand new townhome. And we're so excited. Oh my gosh, I have to show you guys the upstairs. This is so exciting. Look
Wait.
Oh, wow. That's bigger than I thought. I'm gonna show you guys the upstairs, okay? Just stay tuned for this.
Get ready for the best thing and the whole reason why we got this townhome.
This is our whole patio up here. Very own. And then the city is right there. Video doesn't do it justice. Oh my gosh. Oh, we have patio lights. Turn those on. Oh my gosh, this is crazy. Oh my gosh. So here's one. Very exciting stuff, I know. And then laundry room.
Nice.
Guest room. And guest bathroom. Hey! Alright, so we are, oh my gosh, I look like hell. I was like struggling to keep my eyes open. So we're gonna check back in with you tomorrow. We're about to order some Postmates, possibly some poke. So we'll see you guys either tomorrow or in the next vlog. Thank you so much for watching. And I love you guys. I'm hilarious. I'm so sorry. I'm so hungry and tired. Bear with me. I love you. Bye.
What's up, YouTube? It is officially the day we woke up in Colorado. We're so excited. It's 1 p.m. We got a very important mission right now. It's to buy a couch at American Furniture Warehouse. My sister would know what I'm talking about. It's our theme song for this place, but every box, everything, all furniture is cleared out of the U-Haul. We hired movers for 2 hours, and they got everything, although Steve this morning worked his butt off and got some things as well. But, oh my gosh, everything's in. We started unpacking a little bit. Oh, man, it's been a crazy day already, and it's only 1 p.m., but I wanna share with you guys my favorite restaurant ever. It's called Tokyo Joe's. You Colorado peeps know what I'm talking about, but it's just really, really healthy food. You could literally probably eat this all on prep. And Steve got, so this is a poke bowl,
it's with like
salmon
food
and tuna. It's fast food. It's like Chipotle, but I think better. And Steve got a chicken bowl with peanut sauce. So we'll show you guys the process of buying our new couch. And after I eat, though, my mouth's watering because I just thought about my bowl, and I'm about to go ham on it because I'm hungry. All right, this is it. So what we're doing is we're getting, you can piece this together and you can mix and match everything, which is so cool. So we're getting two of these bad boys, and then one cuddler, which is like a bigger cushion. It like curves around, and then another cuddler right here. So our couch is basically gonna do this, and we're excited. They only have half of the sofa in stock. We just need one more piece, but we'll show you when we get it.
At the Rio.
You know me.
Anyways. Skinny Mark.
Not the way to go.
Oh my gosh.
And a what? Mango.
Manberry. You guys know I'm all about that sugar though.
Yeah.
Flashback to
Cabo.
Cabo.
Check out the Cabo vlog.
That is bad.
Rest in peace, sugar.
Fisher.
Always. I got it.